So let's see, where are they found? They are mainly found in the area of region around the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. So if you see the map here, you can see these places marked here in green and orange color. So mainly the regions where they are found is India. So if we talk about India here, so here we have India. Then it is also found in the eastern Brazil region. So this is Brazil and this is the eastern part of Brazil. We also find it in the Myanmar, Vietnam, southern coast of China. So here we have is Vietnam and Myanmar and the southern coast of China here. Apart from that, it is also found in the South and Central America, but it is only in some parts of South and Central America here. It is found in the West Indies. Here we have West Indies out here. Then it is also found in Southeastern Africa. This is your south and this is your part. And of course in Northern Australia also, in some parts we find it. So these are basically the places where we find this tropical deciduous forest. What kind of climates do we have here? Mainly it is dry winters and wet summers. Wet summers means there is a rainfall, especially during the summer seasons, and no rainfall during the winter. So the winters are dry and the summers are wet. The maximum temperature out here is usually high throughout the year. In the rainforest it was still 30 degrees Celsius, but here in this region it is a bit higher from that. The rainfall here is between 70 centimeters to 200 centimeters, the average rainfall, the annual rainfall. The forest here, so let's talk about the forest now, like if you see the pictures here. The soil is richer in nutrients as trees drop their leaves. So this is a region, first of all, where you see here in the picture, the trees are not so densely associated like it was in the rainforest. They're a bit, you know, sparse. They're at a gap. So the trees grow here more sparsely, first of all. Second, we can say the trees are not very tall. If you see here, the trees, the height of the trees is not as tall like in rainforest. It was till 130 was the maximum height, or the minimum was 60 meters that they had. Here the trees are not very tall, and they have the bark of the tree is very thick here. I just said that, you know, the trees, they drop their leaves, and mainly they drop their leaves in the first month of the dry seasons. So what happens in the first month of the dry season, they shed their old leaves and they get the new leaves before the rainy season. So in the first month the leaves fall and the new leaves sprout just before the beginning of the rainy seasons. So mainly they shed their leaves. Important characteristics, how it is different from your evergreen forest. They never shed their leaves, but they shed their leaves almost every year. The animals that we mainly find in this regions are like elephants. We have Asiatic elephants, we have African elephants. So we can say that in this region we get a lot of elephants, lions. We have Asiatic lions and African lions also. We have tigers, different varieties of tigers we get, and we have a lot in India we find. And we know that tiger is also the national animal of India, so we find it in India. Along with that, there are some other animals which are also found in this region, like deers, we have lagoons, monkeys, we have gaur, we have sloth bears, red knee tarantulas, and we have different varieties of birds also that we find in this region. And let's talk about the plants that we get in this region. We have teak. In India we have a lot of plantation of teak wood. We get teak, sal, very common, again we find them in India. We have black palms. It is also one of the main kind of plants that we find in this region. We have bamboos, a lot of bamboo trees that we get, and many people, you know, these days they keep bamboos as a lucky charm in their houses also, according to the feng shuis and all that. So, but the usual bamboo trees are very tall. Then we also have sandalwood forests here, like in India. If we talk about Sundarban, we have a very popular Sundarban forest is all sandalwood forest. And this forest, along with like tropical deciduous or monsoon forest, it is also called seasonal forest, because in this kind of forest we can find different varieties or different seasons we can find, because they have summers and winters, rainy season. So the next one that we are going to talk about is needle leaf forest, or they're also called boreal forests in America. They are called, as the name says, needle leaf. So if you see the leaves, you know, out here, they just look like a needles, you know, the spikes. It has got spikes. So they are called needle leaf forests. So we would be talking about, first of all, where are they found? They are found in east to west, means right from the eastern part of the earth to the western part of the earth. They can be found everywhere, and mainly at 45 degrees north and 75 degrees north across the continent. So if you talk about north 45 degree here to 75 degree north, we find this in this region. It can be in the east also, or it can be in the western part of the world. It is mainly found in the mountains, not very high mountains, but yes, on the hills we find them, and some plateau regions we find them. And mainly they are found in Northern North America. So the Northern part of the North America we find it, and Eurasia. Eurasia means Europe and Asia. So some parts of Europe and Asia find needle leaf forests. So what kind of climates do they need? Usually they have a very short summer season. The summer season out here is not very long as compared to the other forest. Here the winters are cold and long. The normal temperature which we have out here is from 5 degrees Celsius to minus 5 degrees Celsius. So it can vary from region to region, but usually it is 5 degrees Celsius maximum to minimum of minus 5 degrees Celsius. These forests have a dense shade of trees out here. They are like, if you see here, there is quite dark under them. So because there is no sunlight here, or you know, it's dark here, so we have less of lower layer of vegetation. So for a lower layer of vegetation, it needs sunlight. But here, if you see, it's dark, just like a rainforest. They are dark here, so they have a very less lower layer of vegetation. The trees have needle-like leaves, you know, and as I told earlier, why they are called needle leaf forest. The trees, the leaves here are needle-like, and they shed their leaves in several years. They don't shed every year like deciduous forest, but I mean, once in many years they shed their leaves. And there is a low density of trees as compared to other forests. I mean, they're not very thick, but again, no shade out here, very less shade out here we get. So the animals that usually we find in this region of needle leaf forest is your wild sheep. We have rabbits, or we have polar bear or other fur bearing animals. Fur bearing means those animals which have fur on their body. So they are called called fur bearing animals, and they are found in this needle leaf forest usually. The trees or the plants that we get here are mainly coniferous trees like spur and fir here. You can see the picture out here. And in case of boreal forest that is found in America, we have the main tree is larch out here, and it is in some coastal areas also. So we have giant redwoods in these regions of needle leaf forest.